you know, we changed things on it.
You just need to come up with a computer that can talk to Tesla vehicles.
Yeah, yeah. Tesla's got a great system to figure it out. They're not concerned with remanufacturing like we are.
Yeah.
I hate to compare myself to them because I feel that they blow me out of the water.
Yeah. Who knows, they might see this and come talk to us, right?
Yeah.
I telling my wife, have you seen that little robot, the Honda Osimo?
Yes.
So I'm like, when that hits the market, babe, I'm gonna buy one. And then whenever they start failing, I'm going to be the junkyard for Honda Osimos.
There we go.
She's like, you're an idiot. And I'm like, so well. I always wanted to start like the like a high-end junkyard, you know, like Ferraris or crash Maseratis or Bugattis. I'd be the guy with the headlight that needed for that, you know, for that specific vehicle.
Yeah.
Is a common lifespan for a Toyota battery about 6 years?
No. Toyota, referring to the nickel-based battery, not the lithium. Lithium are primarily the plug-ins. It's, I want to say, on average, 11, 12 years.
Really?
Yeah. There are a lot of other variables that can lead to premature failure. For example, we've seen taxi cab batteries kill brand new batteries in less than 2 years. But on the opposite end, we have clients that are couriers, and they deliver subpoenas to what is it? It's Arizona, Nevada, Oregon, and California. So they're on the road with these cars 24/7, on the freeway cruising 80 miles an hour, barely using the battery, get over 400,000 miles on a battery. Another extreme example is the typical old lady that only drives to church and the grocery store.
Old lady in Pasadena.
Yeah. So she's not going to put many miles, but since she's preserved it so well, driven it frequently and driven it little, the batteries wind up going 15, 16 years.
So why do you think that is? Why do you think short drives, like a taxi cab, wipes out a battery as opposed to taking those long trips to other states?
Well, taxi cabs are running almost 24/7.
Okay.
The taxi cab companies, how the majority of them work, at least the ones that we're familiar with, they have these cars running 24/7. They get a van with 8 drivers and they go to each taxi, switch out the driver from the car, keep that car going. It almost never turns off. The taxi cabs aren't always short, simple drives. Sometimes they're long. They're also sitting there waiting for their next client to come, where the battery's charging up and down because the AC is on, which is damaging the battery without putting miles on it. So it's, yeah, that's why you've got to have mileage constraints on batteries for warranties. An analogy with the cell phone is you leave it on, plugged in charging, and running your music and video or something that pulls
every single
a lot of
app
power.
You have on the phone.
Yeah, so the battery throughout the day, instead of consuming 3,000 milliamps, because you're doing so much, it's going to consume 6,000. But you're pumping it back in, you're cycling the battery up and down. Engines wear out from friction. Batteries, for the most part, wear out from being cycled up and down. The more energy that they have to take in and put out, the sooner they, or the closer they get to the end of their life. The ideal way to preserve a battery as long as possible is to drive it frequently, because you want to stimulate the battery and you want to drive it at a constant speed. So the battery is not pushing power out or sucking it back in. It'll stay at a roughly static charge.
Okay.
But that's not realistic. Very few people fit into those parameters. The people that do are the people doing long drives.
So if you can, you want to save your Prius battery or, you know, a hybrid battery, take long trips.
Yes. Exactly.
So on Chris's video on his changing out the Prius battery, I'll put a link in the description below, a guy named Indrid Cole, nice reference to Mothman, asks, he got in there and he saw a bunch of sticky syrup stuff and he's like, is my battery leaking? Probably not, right?
Right. With our experience with the thousands of batteries that we've replaced, remanufactured, I've never found anything like that other than soda. Some people spill soda, it goes into the cracks and they don't clean it up. So it evaporates and all you're left with is the syrup.
That's right.
Inside of the batteries, the only liquid is the electrolyte, and it looks just like water. And I think he would have elaborated on what it looked like if it was battery acid, because the acid eats the galvanization off of the metal and causes a lot of discoloration and even growth sometimes.
Even what?
Growth.
Growth.
Yeah, you'll start to see it kind of look like corrosion on battery terminals.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, in his situation, so,
a mushroom or soda.
A mushroom?
Yeah, like growth. Like.
Oh, no, no, no. Okay, okay. No, no mushrooms grown in the batteries.
If you like, cut a battery open, like one of the, would anything come out?
Yeah, at first, the initial puncture you're going to get, because they're all under pressure, unless you bring it down to a cold temperature. But on the inside, I mean, you open it up, you're not going to learn anything by looking at it. It just looks like the Prius one is just metal plates with liquid. The liquid is an acid. When it's gotten on our rags and stuff, it'll discolor them and even eat holes through them. So yeah. It's caustic.
It's like a standard regular 12-volt battery.
Yeah.
In the car.
Yeah, just like a lead-acid battery.
Anything you want to interject? Anything you want to tell people about yourself? Or
I love the question about the dealer. That's a big one that we get. Why would people choose us over the dealer? And the number one reason is the service, how we take care of you, you know, our clients.
What sets you apart?
First, gosh, and this isn't speaking for all dealerships, but from the majority of dealerships that I've been to, seen, and, you know, heard stories of, sets us apart is service. You know, very personable. You call, you talk with either myself, Tyler, or Joe. We tell you what's going on with your car. Exactly. We send you pictures. We send you videos straight to your cell phone. You make your own decision on what you'd like to do. Okay. We just inform you of the problems your car has, and then you decide. There's no pressure. There's not a single person here on commission. So whether you choose to do, you know, $10,000 in work or you just do an oil change, doesn't make a difference to them. Whereas most dealerships, the technicians are under incentive. Okay. So the more they sell you, the more they make. And we commonly see people get quoted different prices for same things. I mean, we've seen hybrid batteries sell from the dealership as low as $2,500, as high as $5,000 from the same dealership.
No.
Mm-hmm. We have
same exact battery?
Same exact battery.
Oh.
We've got copies of the invoices and all. So here, there's none of that.
What dealership is that?
I don't want to.
No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. I'd be happy to show you the invoice. But.
So yeah, I mean, he's here in Orange County, California, Chris, Electron Automotive. Anything you won't work on? I mean, Hondas, Toyotas, obviously Teslas. If someone has a BMW out there, do you want to take a look at it for them?
Yeah, we service everything here.
Okay.
I mean, we even do regular cars, but almost all of our clients that bring us regular cars are those who have hybrids. They say, hey, I'd love for you to work on my wife's car, but she's got a Ford Explorer.
Okay.
So we take care of those for them.
Okay.
But easily 80% of our work is hybrids.
If you guys are going to call and get work done, tell them you saw them on Bundy's Garage.
Absolutely.
And let's go take a look at
the battery
department. Battery shop.
Let's go.
Chris, thank you so much, man. It's a pleasure.
Absolutely. Bye.